So I'm joined here today by Kerry and Peter from DxE, which is Direct Action Everywhere. It's a campaign group. And you've been in the news recently, but did you just want to start off by just telling the audience about what you're about and what you stand for and what your aims are? Mm-hmm. Peter?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, so basically we're Direct Action Everywhere.
Yeah.
It's an organisation that was founded over in America. And basically the idea behind it is to disrupt the speciesist mindset that is current throughout all of our society. And basically, right now we live in a society where there is a state of normalized violence towards animals. And this is a state that is completely normalized. People don't know, people don't think about this all the time, even though it's right there in front of them. It's kind of too big for them to see, almost. And so DxE is about disrupting that and bringing forward the discussion about whether that is right or wrong. And in our view, it is wrong. And I think actually everyone who really looks at it will agree with that, because everyone is against animal cruelty.
Yeah. And basically, you've been involved in a lot of campaigning activity in Brighton, particularly at Tesco, I think, for shops that sell fur, I think Steakhouse, Hisby. Mm-hmm. So, Kerry, did you just want to talk about kind of where you've been involved, you know, what action you've been involved in Brighton, and what the aims of that action were?
Yeah, well, it's everywhere that, like you said, sort of normalises violence against animals. So we've been to Tesco and Waitrose, like big supermarkets, as well as local shops like Hisby, places that sell fur and leather and like other animal products, and a steakhouse as well. So just everywhere. We're not targeting individuals or individual businesses. It's just everywhere that you know, this sort of violence against animals is normalised.
And basically, you're non-violent, which is an important thing to to point out. So ultimately, you're kind of against any use of kind of animal products, really. So it's everything from, you know, eating meat products, but also, you know, using leather for clothing, that kind of thing, right? Is that the whole full spectrum?
Exactly, because it's not just that the animal dies, it's also that we use these animals. So in effect, that basically animal use is animal abuse, because we shouldn't have the right to control their body and control and take away the right of their, like, their bodily integrity. And we do that every time we buy an animal product.
And what would the protest normally consist of then? You'd go into, like, say, Tesco, I think you hold up kind of photos of animals almost like before and after, in a way, isn't it, I think?
Yeah.
What's the process involved? What, more importantly, what kind of reaction do you get?
Well, it's usually the photos aren't really graphic, usually. So, you know, if people are walking past, they're not immediately faced with a really graphic photograph. It's usually just pictures of animals, maybe an animal sort of in a factory farm or in a cage or something. There's usually a speech about what these animals go through, how they ended up, you know, on the shelves or wherever they are. And I mean, the reaction, obviously, from the shop owners is never good, but that's not the aim of it. It's more to sort of create this discussion. Again, from the public, maybe at the time, some people are supportive and some people aren't. But, you know, in the long run, where it's created national debate and discussion, it has been positive.
So how do you see the DxE kind of progressing? What do you, particularly in Brighton, but also elsewhere? I mean, we must say veganism's getting a lot more popular. You know, a lot of the big kind of food chains or food producers are turning to the vegan market and making vegan products. So that is, you know, that's, I think there is change happening, but where do you see the next few years?
Yeah, so for DxE Brighton and across the world, I think it will be a continuation of what's happening now. We will continue to disrupt the normalised violence as we see it. And so anywhere that there is that happening and animals are being abused, the products of these abused animals are being sold, then we will be there to disrupt that and raise the question and try and disrupt the mental model that everyone has at the moment, which is a speciesist mental model that says that we as humans, because we are humans, have the right to unnecessarily kill and use others for no necessary reason. And so it will be a continuation of that. And it will keep growing.